She's not doing the big screens now. We're driving around in circles, man. Hey, somebody check the map. Check the map. Check the map.
Where are those quails?
Where are quails? I'm supposed to be here. Where are those quails? Where are those quails? We're in the fucking Oklahoma City. I know we're lost. I know we're lost.
Mescalito Gonzito may have been spending down a week in South Texas, there in the middle of Texas, Shinnery, Sandy, south of Big Springs, and we're up in Dallas in the Cochina having some, anticipating some quail enchiladas, possible the best in the world, and that there was this horrible open mic, but it was still worth it because we had tequila.
I don't want to masturbate no more. I got my hands on top of my conscious mind. I'm pushing down this rail. I'm gonna step over it. Candace, your nipples are like bluebirds. Candace, you're melting upward an hour deep into your belly.
He said he thought the world would go deaf, and I said I was sure of it, and that in fact the bar had been lowered so much by karaoke that people couldn't even tell the difference between good and evil. And then the food and drink came, and we just ended our conversation. Put it in that file where things that can't be fixed get stored, like harmonicas and relationships and political careers and socks.
Yeah, it just never gets weird enough for me, you know. When it gets weird, the word get professional. I there's nothing to do with that stuff. I think I'm gonna have to go see that blues monkey.
Yow, I'm the blues monkey. You don't be nobody like me. Yow, I'm the blues monkey. I can do one, two, three. Yes, yes, I'm the blues monkey. That's who I am. Yes, really got you down. I came in from Nigeria. I only spoke over China. That's right, I'm the blues monkey. You know me, I'm the blues monkey. Tell your mama, tell your mama.
Yeah, blues monkey, I really like your show, man. I love this good show.
Where's the horse outside? I learned it from the primary linguistic department of the University of Oklahoma. First sign language. Then I learned another. Seven.
Yes, he was alive. I'm sorry. No, I saw him too. He was alive. No, honestly, he's still. Oh, he's alive. I know. He's alive. Yeah, everybody thinks he shot himself, but he's living in there. He's down in Texas right now.
The deafness of humanity haunted me for some time after that encounter. And the more I observed the herd, the less they heard. People, or should I say sheeple, are so wound up in their personal quagmires, they become oblivious to life's multitude of benefits, like free sunsets, sex on diving boards, really good music. When I was young, I had witnessed entire rooms stand in rapture, enchanted by a great vocalist or an amazing solo. How did this get replaced by a drunk female dribbling survive? Come on, sheeple. You got three options. You're going to get shaved, you're going to get eaten, or you're going to move to Arkansas.